soldiers.
Grammy!
What?
How do I choose a tamper for my portafilter?
When she calls me Grammy, that alludes to Christmas presents and birthday presents. You know, that's what you do for your granddaughters.
I know.
But
and you know what? It's been 4 years and I haven't got a one from you, Gail.
And guess what?
No Christmas.
I'm not old enough to
while
be your
I'm
grandmother.
Talking.
Okay, so how do I choose a tamper for my portafilter?
Yeah, so well, you know, if you said you want to know your diameter,
well,
right?
Yeah, a rough idea what the, you know, millimeters is in here.
So what's this guy?
53. Just like that.
Which is
see, this
fine.
Says this is the Rattleware one. It says 53 on there.
I can't see that on the camera, unfortunately.
Okay.
But
okay.
Yeah,
53.
We'll believe you.
This is the Rancho Silvio, 58. This is the Nuovo Simonelli, 58. This is not a 58. This is the Dream Machine by Ascaso, 57. Fits
okay.
It perfect. And the let's skip that one.
Okay.
We're gonna go over here to the Rocket, a nice 58.
Mm-hmm.
This also is a 58. This is the Pasquini. However, if you'll notice, this basket has a ridge in it here,
mm-hmm.
and it also tapers in. You can only go so far with the 58, and if you push on it hard, it will get stuck.
I know you've seen that, Joy, before.
I've done it numerous times. So, you really want to use a 57 in a Pasquini, because then it will work just nice.
What about the, I know that the Ranchillo has a little bit of a taper. Do you want to do 57 in that, or is a 58 okay with that?
It goes down plenty far. Look how far
okay.
down it goes. So your coffee's typically going to be up at this ridge when you're done, so it's going well below that. The ridge
got
is just
it.
At the top of the tamper.
Okay.
This one is just, I've done it. I mean, I've gotten it stuck where I had to pry it out with a screwdriver, forgetting what I was doing.
All right.
So.
And so, like, people will say, hey, there's some space. Like this guy, the 58,
yeah.
There's some space around it.
Well, you got to have a little space to get it in. You could do a custom-made one by Reg Barber.
Yeah.
Get it right down to the millimeter if that's what you want to do. But I think you're going to find out that you got to have just a teeny bit of space.
A teeny bit of
See?
Space.
That one's not bad. And the other, now there's others too, like the La Pavoni.
Mm-hmm.
Millennium series, which is pre-2000, they take a 49, and then after 2000, they take a 51.
Okay.
It's a very small portafilter. It's very small. We should have brought it up, but we didn't. But it looks a lot like this, only very small.
Okay.
And then there are like some DeLonghi's and some of those are kind of odd sizes too. They're like 51s.
Okay.
And those are odd sizes. You would probably have to. These are the common sizes.
The older Breville's also around 51 too, but the newer mm-hmm. models are at the 58. The larger's.
The yeah.
I don't know about the 840 though.
No, the 840's.
Is that 51?
Nah,
is that?
It's an odd size. I'd have to check it out. It's
okay.
It's the double boiler that's a 58.
Yeah, I know the double boiler is.
And
I don't know about the Barista Express or the
right.
the Infusa.
I know the Barista Express is another different size too. It's not the 51. It's something. Maybe
56, 53. Okay.
But anyway, you can check your own machine and see what's going on.
So that's our big sort of like thing, how to choose it. You know, first of all, look at the diameter.
Uh-huh.
Check out the basket if possible.
See how it fits?
Best
look at
thing,
that. That's a nice fit.
Yeah, best thing is if you have access to, you know, take the portafilter somewhere and
yes.
test them out. That's going to be the best.
That's the best.
Cool.
All right.
Thanks, Gail.
See you later.